We're starting to like the 7th of November. Thank you so much for coming tonight and for waiting for this. I think the province has been waiting for this for a while, and we're just very grateful that you're all here. Thanks, Dennis, for the kind introduction. Before I say anything at all, I have some thank yous that are very important for me to take care of. Permit me to say, first and foremost, thank you to Tammy and our kids, Megan, Coulter, and Faith. There they are. Tammy, I love you. I know, you know, I've told you this many times, but I just couldn't do this job without you, and I'm just so grateful for your support and in this campaign for your hard work in a couple of constituencies or more across the province. And for the kids, you know, they put up with a lot if their dad's in politics, and they've never been anything but supportive, truly, and encouraging to me. And I'm just so grateful to Megan and Coulter and Faith. So thank you guys very, very much. And for the unqualified honor that I have to represent the people of Swift Current constituency in the Legislative Assembly, let me say to all of the voters through you tonight, thank you very much, Swift Current and District, for this great honor. I can't do the other job unless I first have the chance to do this job, and it's something that I'll never take for granted. And I appreciate the chance to voice Swift Current concerns to the government in Regina. I have since 1999. Thank you. Thanks again. You know, I am the most delinquent candidate in all of the province for the Saskatchewan Party. I don't get to do a lot of door knocking, and by not a lot, I mean any, in this campaign, because we were traveling around the province. And so permit me to name some names of an amazing campaign team we have here, and I'm going to miss some a few of them, and I apologize in advance, but I'm going to name some. I'm going to name John and Alice Wall, my mom and dad. On Saturday, we dropped by the office for a bit, and Dad said, I'm glad the campaign's over, or almost over, and I think he was expressing the views of a whole lot of people. I also have to thank someone who's chaired or co-chaired my campaign since I first started running in 99, Mr. Brian Campbell. Yes, sir. And I'm going to run through some names here. The president of our constituency, Lyle Quinton, and his wife, Pat, on the executive, did an amazing job of campaigning. Shauna Fiagasuna, Jackie and Randy and Ryan and Joel and Kim and Dwight. And I'm going to, again, miss some. Don, and I apologize for that, but thank you so much for all that you've done. I need to acknowledge the architects, the designers, and the operators of our central campaign. I think the very, very best in the country. And yes, I'm going to mention some more names. The co-chairs, Joe Donlevy and Bill Boyd. And yeah. Reg Downs, Terry Harris, Kathy Young, Patrick Bundrock, Shannon, Megan, Cole, Graham, Drew, Blaze, Lisa, Steve, Leanne, Derek, Rebecca, Sam, Kaylee, and Kyla. It's worth mentioning their names. I'll probably mention a few. They ran a remarkable campaign, as good as you'd find anywhere in the country, and they deserve recognition tonight. And to the incomparable crew of the canola van, that's the leaders' tour. Later on in the campaign, we became known as the Jack Wagon. I'll let you figure out why that is. With some disputes every now and then, to my indispensable friend, Swift Current's own Everett Hindley, and Ian Hanna. And Ian Hanna and Roland LaFrance, thanks, fellas, for another tour around this amazing province. Thank you to every single Saskatchewan Party candidate that ran in this election. We were so proud of the field of women and men that we were able to attract to the party to bear our standard. They stepped up and they stepped out in leadership in our province, and a whole bunch of them got elected tonight right across the province. But to all of them, I just want to say to them and their teams and their families, thank you very, very, very much. And a word to every single candidate that sought election in this particular contest right across the province, regardless of the party that they ran for. In just a few days, we will mark Remembrance Day. And we're going to honor the sacrifice of so many for all of us. Sacrifice to the name of freedom and democracy. We honor their gift to us best when we participate in democracy, and there's no greater participation in democracy than to step forward, put your name on a lawn sign, and run for office regardless of the party, and we owe them a thank you and an acknowledgement tonight from here in Swift Current. May I offer a special acknowledgement to our main opponents in this contest, the New Democratic Party of this province. A short time ago, I took a call from Mr. Lingenfelter, who very graciously conceded the election and wished us well and offered a new government any help that we might require. I want to thank him for that call, and through him to his campaign and his team, I want to thank them for their campaign, for the presentation of their ideas, because I think it helped inform the debate, not just of the campaign, but what comes in the weeks after. And we ought to thank them for their effort and for their participation in democracy and for the opposition I know they're going to provide for the province over the next number of years. And most of all, I want to just say tonight how grateful we are on behalf of all of the members of our party and people who ran for us across Saskatchewan, for the humbling honor, for the opportunity to serve in government for the next 4 years. We're going to work very, very hard not to let anybody down in this province. You know, people from across the country might be looking in on us tonight and wondering what happened in Saskatchewan this evening. Because if you've been following politics in the last little while, you've seen a real resurgence, an orange resurgence, even an orange wave across the country. You've seen it in the federal election and in various provincial elections, and one might reasonably ask the question, where is that surge in the province of Saskatchewan? Well, what those folks may not know is that in this province, green is the color. My friends, today in Saskatchewan is a very special day in our province, and actually not because of this election, not because of the honor we now have of serving in government for the next 4 years. It's a special day in Saskatchewan because of the province that you have built, because what you have done, because of the blessings of good fortune and providence that we mark well today that is making this province a leader in the country. You know, over the last 4 years, I heard a lot of great stories and anecdotes about this new Saskatchewan. The best was from a panel discussion that happened a couple of years ago, I think in Saskatoon. They were talking about this new, you know, quote-unquote, new Saskatchewan. And a woman said, quote, "My friends and family members from other places would always ask me, why do you still live there? Why haven't you moved away from Saskatchewan?" She said, "Do you know what I like about the new Saskatchewan? They don't ask me that anymore." Yeah. Do you know why they don't ask her that anymore? It's because of all of you, not because of a government. It's because of the province that you have built. It's because of the fact that today in Saskatchewan, our economy is leading the nation. It's because of the fact that today in Saskatchewan, there are 26,400 more jobs than there were just 4 years ago, and we have the lowest unemployment rate in the nation. It's because, yeah. It's because today in Saskatchewan, there were thousands more people eligible to vote. Why today? Because more people are living here than ever before, and young people, I can see you out there, are choosing to stay right here in the province of Saskatchewan and build their futures here. It's because today in Saskatchewan, we're doing our best to reinvest the dividends of that growth, to shorten surgical wait times, to open new long-term care beds in the province, to hire more nurses, to hire more doctors, admittedly with more work needed to be done. It's because today in Saskatchewan, we're investing in highways. We've invested 64% more in highways in our first four than the last 4 years before the last election. It's because today in Saskatchewan, there is 44% less general revenue fund debt in Saskatchewan, $3 billion paid off because of all of you and all that you have done. It's because today in Saskatchewan, taxes are lower for everyone, for families and for small business owners, for farmers. Today in Saskatchewan, there is a government that has never forgotten, nor will it ever forget, the importance of rural Saskatchewan and of agriculture to this provincial economy. And it's because today in Saskatchewan, ladies and gentlemen, there's a government that's working hard to keep the promises that it made in the last election. I've had people say, you know, we didn't agree with everything you promised in the last election, but at least you've done what you said you would do. And today in politics, that counts for something. Today in Saskatchewan, people voted for a place that has been transformed in the last few years. A place whose very attitude has changed, whose outlook may never be the same again. They voted for tomorrow. They chose to move this province forward today. They chose to continue with the growth agenda, a plan that builds on our record over the last 4 years. They chose a balanced budget platform that commits to help students and parents save for their kids' education, that commits to help families and seniors. They chose a vision of Saskatchewan as the best place to live in the country for those with disabilities or for their families. They chose a commitment to a better healthcare system, less ideological and more efficient and more compassionate. They chose to continue to invest in education and to continue the task of dealing with the infrastructure debt. They chose a Saskatchewan that will be 1.1 million people by 2015. That's our vision. And that will be debt-free, ladies and gentlemen. They chose a government that is committed to the excellence of this province, to our place in a world that wants energy security and food security. They said yes to a province that would be the best place in Canada in which to live and to work and to invest. And by the way, do you know what that is? That vision? Well, that's just the promise of Saskatchewan. It started over 100 years ago. And we intend to work every single day to keep that promise of Saskatchewan. And we will do what we said we would do in this particular campaign. And ladies and gentlemen, as a government, we're going to do it with humility. We will do it with an attitude of service. We will accept this high honor given us tonight to serve the people of this province, and that's the operative word. We will be a government that works hard. We will be a government that keeps its promises, that admits easily of mistakes. We will make them. We'll take responsibility for them. We will fix them. And we will be a government that pursues growth for our province, but never as a goal in and of itself, but for the quality of life that it will provide for this generation and for future generations. One of my favorite quotes is from George Eliot, a 19th century writer who said, quote, "It is never too late to become what you might have been." Our province has waited a long time, but today Saskatchewan is becoming what it might have been, what it should have been, what it was meant to be, and we're not going back. After years of losing our young people to other provinces, our population is now growing, and those young people are staying, and we're not going back. Today, after years of being a have-not province, we are a have province, and a leader in this country, and we are not going back. Today, after years of lagging behind the rest of the provinces in this country, we are leading in so very many respects, and we are not going back. Where once there was a fear of the future, now there is hope. Where once there was doubt, now there is confidence. This new Saskatchewan that you have built is stronger and prouder and better than it has ever been, and we are not going back. We've chosen to move forward, ladies and gentlemen, tonight as a province. Saskatchewan has chosen to plant its standard, to set its course for the future, to be a leader, a national leader, even an international leader. Not the place to be from, but the place to be. There is still work to do, but I know we are up to the challenge, because Saskatchewan people are facing their future today with hope and with optimism, for they know this, the only day better than today in Saskatchewan is tomorrow in Saskatchewan. May God bless our province.